guys, welcome back to my channel. Yes, another video, another day. We are going in with the bangers. This is what you guys wanted to see. This is guys what you guys would subscribe for. I feel like I'm drooling everywhere. I probably am. I apologize. This video will be fall inspired. I was feeling very fall, as you can see with the lip and the eyes. And if you want to see what this video entails and you want to see how I achieve this look, just keep watching. And oh, don't forget to subscribe. All right, let's continue with the video. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna use is my Goof Proof brow pencil. Let's see if you guys can see it, maybe not. And I'm gonna use this on my brows. I'm gonna use my little MAC powder, the mirror, so I can see a detail. So I like to brush it up first. I don't really do my brows on camera too much because I don't know. I just think I do it faster off camera. This is in the shade of number 5. I don't know if you guys can see that, but number 5. The key is using a soft hand. And then at the very, very tip, we're just gonna lightly do soft strokes. It's okay if you make mistakes, you can go back in with the concealer and seal everything. Next, I'm gonna take my LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Toffee, and I'm gonna go ahead and outline my brows. I'm gonna use this flat brush from Amazon. What I like to do is just put it on the tip. Yeah, it depends on how I feel. Sometimes I put it on the tip, and sometimes I'll just draw it on. So I'm gonna show you both techniques. This is the one if I decide to put it on the tip. It depends on how comfortable you feel. So let me get my little handy dandy mirror and come in just a little bit closer. And that's just the one if you put it on the brush. So if I decided to do the other way, which I kind of be careful for the splashes. Take some off the top, because this is slightly too much. And then with my mirror, we're just gonna slowly outline this side as well. I'm not a fan of going all the way down my midline. I just think this is too much. So it depends on what you're comfortable with. I like to kind of like raise that brow up so I can see, and then I bring it down into the eyelid. Might as well, right? Okay, so you saw both techniques. Oops, I didn't realize I was all up in the camera. But you saw both techniques. So you have to decide which one you prefer most. Sometimes I go on the top, but today I don't feel like it. So we're not doing the top. Sometimes I take my blending brush here. And I go ahead and I blend it in. Like so, like that. Obviously on the other side. Remember, brows are sisters, not twins. So of course you're not gonna make it even, but close to even as possible is always the goal. And come in just a little bit more so you can see. All right, okay. So now that's done, I'm gonna take my spoolie and brush up. And do it on this side. boom, brows done. Okay, so next I'm gonna take my lovely base primer. And this is a French primer. My cousin gave this to me, so I'm not sure where you can purchase it at. But I really like it. But sometimes it does come off a lot. So I just like to put it right here. Not too much, because it could get, I can look really pale off of this. And I'm gonna take my regular foundation brush. I just like to put it all over. The key to a flawless foundation is the primer. If your base is a mess, you won't have good results. For me, I like to go straight head first into the eyes because I just don't like when I put on foundation, I put the eye, I think it's just too much. So I like to use my NYX white base and I put it over my lids. And that'll make the color pop. The last time I did my makeup, I found that I put a little too much. But the color came out so pigmented, I was extremely happy about that. I'm just gonna put a tad bit too much. I'm probably gonna look like a freak, but it's okay. But you guys are gonna see the look come together. Okay, so I have the NYX white base. I don't know if you guys can see that. And then I like to use my e.l.f. eye crease brush to apply it on. I like to like just dab it. Yeah. If you think that you can't get the colors right from your eyeshadow palette, most likely you need to use a base and it'll pop out even more. Not saying it won't pop out, but it's gonna pop out even more. So I'm just like to dab that on there like this. Like I said, you're gonna look a crazy mess, but I'm telling you, it's worth it. Okay, so now that I applied that, I'm gonna take this controlled setting brush. It's not really made for this, but we're just gonna set it in. There's nothing on this brush. This brush has absolutely nothing on it. But I like to bring it all the way up on the whole lid, like this, and then that way it's blended out. And I like to make sure I keep my eyes open so I can see, because obviously you need to see where the color is gonna go if your eyes is open. So yeah, okay. I don't set this, I don't do none of that. This is where you make the decision on what colors you're gonna do. So I think I'm a little bit more into the fall inspired since we're about to roll into fall, and I'm gonna use one of my Morphe palettes and apply that color. Okay, so I decided I wanted to be extra, so I have my, I don't know if you can see that. Okay, I can't see it. But my Ben 9 translucent powder, and I'm just gonna go ahead and set that. Now we're gonna go do the colors. All right, so I have my Morphe 35V palette that it was gifted to me. Let's see if I can get it. It's so beautiful. Look at this baby. Isn't this gorgeous? So I'm gonna use Wild Glow, which is in the middle. And I'm also gonna use Private Party, which is that goldish right there in the middle as well. This is stunning. This will definitely get me in the fall. Sorry about that, the glare. There we go, the fall feeling. So we're gonna use Wild Glow. If I remove my hands, the whole thing's gonna fall off. And Private Party. So that's what the move is today. I'm gonna get my blending brush. I know it's dirty, I'm so sorry. But I did use like a paper towel, brush it on there and nothing comes off. So it's just the blue from the last time. So I'm gonna go ahead and use Wild Thing. Y'all, this look is gonna come together. I feel it, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and start on the outer part of my lid. So of course, make sure your eye is up, you know, that way you'll know where to go if you have a hooded eyes like me. And we're gonna start off slowly and blend that out. Okay, we don't wanna touch our brow bone, of course not. That's just so 2005. But we're gonna just slightly go a little bit under that. Look at how beautiful this is. Look at how it applies with pigment. And that's what we are striving for. Look at how beautiful these color or this color is. Like, this is stunning. I don't really have to do much, you know, which is lovely. Okay, so next I'm gonna just slightly take the Risqué color, and I'm gonna put that just slightly in my inner corner just to warm it up a little bit. I don't want to stay too dark, so I want to create that color gradient just to give me that fall feeling. So I'm just gonna just slightly take it and go right at the outer corner. Look at how beautiful and pigment this is. Excellent. So we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So we have definitely put the Risqué color on both sides, which is lovely. So now we're gonna change our brush. Go ahead and use the Private Party color and use that on the inner corner. Okay, like this. Look at how pretty these colors are. Like, you can't tell me these colors are not beautiful together. So what we're gonna do is go back with our blending brush with the excess color, and we're just gonna go ahead and blend everything out. We don't want anything too harsh. Not too much. We don't want to erase anything. So that's it. I want to create more of a dramatic look. So I'm going to go back with my NYX white base and also a flat angled brush. That way we can, you know, cut. Okay. So there's nothing on it. So I'm going to slightly take this and I'm going to do a cut crease, a white cut crease. I'm just going to go literally where the like a little bit above my lid, that way I can just cut crease it. So let's see if it works. I'm gonna be mad if it doesn't. Ooh, look at it. I'm impressed. This is like my first time officially doing a cut crease, and I am highly impressed. Wow. So it's okay if you have like a little bit of excess lines. We can fix that with an eyeshadow. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side. Okay, so I got a tiny flat brush and I dipped it in the Wild Thing. That way we can color correct a little bit where we kind of went off track. is gonna go slightly like this. That way we can clean that up just a little bit. Ooh, look at that. We can kind of clean that up just a little bit. Boom. Look at how pretty that looks. So we're just gonna go a little bit more towards the inside. Boom. Okay, we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So now that we cleaned up both sides, oh my God, y'all, I'm so proud. So this is how it looks. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and just continue with the rest of my face. With these two highlighters, this one is a little bit like a tone down and this one is a little bit bright. So I think for this video, I'm probably gonna use this one because I don't use this one very often, but it does still give like a beautiful natural glow. And I'm just gonna lightly dust that on here. But this one you have more is, what's the phrase, less is more? But this one actually you have to put more for it to show up. The other one, less is more. So, see, look at that, beautiful. See, I have to like rub it back and forth for it to like show up a little bit. So next we're gonna move on to the eyeliner. This is the II Captain from TJ Maxx. I needed eyeliner, TJ Maxx, I was already in there, and this was like $2, but the best $2 of my life because it works, okay? So we're gonna have double the wing, okay? So I hope I don't mess up on camera. Usually I do the best. It's like a one-shot deal for me. This is my one-shot deal. Why my wing look like it's disabled? Okay. Let's do the other side. Oh, that actually didn't turn out too bad. I thought it was looking disabled. Okay. Ow. So that's that. So I'm gonna go ahead and put my lashes on off camera and then we're gonna come back for the lip. So my lashes are now on and the look is still looking complete. We're gonna use this Maybelline Color Sensational Shaping Lip Liner. This is the shade Concrete Jungle. And I'm gonna go ahead and line my lips. I feel like I'm drooling. I know I'm not, but I feel like I am. Okay. So I'm just gonna go ahead and shade just slightly in that way. The color that we're gonna do. The e.l.f. Matte Lip Color in Wine. This is gonna tie the look together. I'm so excited. How do you open it? This is my first time using it, can you tell? I don't know how to put this on, so we're gonna do this to the best of our abilities here. Ew. I don't like how it glides on here. Is this MAC? No, this is ELF. Wow, I tried it. Oh, this is pretty. I didn't know how to put it on, but once it's on, it looks nice. So I'm gonna go ahead and do a little bit more of my inside, because you know when you smile, right? And then like you see like pink, and you see all that pink? Ooh, fancy. Okay, so this is the look. So what I'm gonna do is fix up my hair and come back and do a outro for you guys, okay? All right, give me 1 second. Make sure you like, subscribe, share with all your friends, turn your notifications on, that way you know every time you get a video from me. Just stay tuned for more, okay? Bye.